Welcome to Office 2013, video number 49. Hey, we're still studying Access. Two videos ago, we created a bunch of tables to store raw data. We created our forms. And then last video, we created all these queries. In this video, just a quick short video about creating reports. We're going to take some of our queries and create reports. So for example, inventory value, if I double click and open it, the current value on all of our products are these products, these values. We'd like to print that out as a report. So check this out. Just like when we created our forms, we selected a table and clicked a button to create our forms. Here, we're going to click on our query, go up to Create. And over in Report, I'm simply going to click this Report button. This produces a report in Layout. We can, for a simple query where we don't have lots of columns and don't need to change a lot of things, this is a nice one-click method to get a nice report. Now, there is this count down here in this in-between Layout view. And by the way, we can come up here and see there's Print Preview, Layout View, which is this in-between view we're using, Design View. We use Design View for queries and tables. We're using Layout View for reports and for forms. Here's our Print Preview. I don't like the way that looks, right? Close Print Preview. Go back over to Home, View, and I want to go to Layout View. And here, we could change the height by pointing to the edge and dropping it down. That tells us the count. I don't really want to know that. So I'm simply going to point to the edge. And we see that cursor right there. We saw that with word tables. That means we could highlight the whole row and delete. All right, I'm going to Control S and call this inventory value. And instantly, we have down here a new section called reports. So tables, queries, forms, and reports, those are all the objects we're learning how to create in this class. Now, if I close this, next time I come and open this, there we have our inventory report. And it is dynamic. Close this. If I come up to Products Form and double click it, and I'm going to change Barnyard Friends. On hand is 30. When I click OK, I don't have to save it because that's raw data. Not only will the table update, so there's our 30. The inventory value query updates. There's our Barnyard Friends now valued at 810. And finally, our inventory value report. Boom, all the way from our form, it rippled through the table, the queries, and now the report. That is amazing. That's what makes this Access database so useful. Now I'm going to close this, go back to the products form, and change it back to 3. We were just checking to see how awesome this database is. Now we want to create one more report, reorder phone list. Now this time we're going to go to Create. And in the Reports group, we're going to use the wizard. It'll give us a few more options in how we want to see this report. So in step one, be sure and select the correct thing, whatever it is, table or query. I'm going to select Reorder Phone List. I can choose amongst all my fields. I'm going to select first name and then click that arrow to jump that field over to this report. Telephone, I'm going to jump that over. On hand is what I want next, and then sell price, and then description. I'm not going to include supplier code or product ID. Now notice some of these fields are from the supplier table, first name and telephone. The other three are from our products table. Click Next. Here, how do we want to view? It's already showing us a type of grouping. It's going to show first name and telephone number. And then under it, it will show all of the toys for that one supplier. Next, this is a step for grouping. Now, we've already grouped because we have data from two different tables. But if you didn't have data from two different tables, you could use this grouping step to group things. For example, if you had calculated GPA by major, you could group it by major. You'd simply select this and then select that as your field to group. I'm going to click Next. Sorting. I'm going to say on hand, ascending. Next. stepped. That means it will show the supplier name and telephone number. And then below it, it'll show all of the toys. I'm definitely going to orientate this one landscape. Click Next. Supplier data, I don't want that as my report title. Something like reorder phone list. I want to preview my report and then click Finish. Now, sometimes with the wizards, the report doesn't come out looking so good, but no problem. We're in print preview. I'm going to close it and then go change the view, home, view, and I'm going to go to this layout view. Now, for our queries and our tables, we use design view, and it's perfectly all right to use this design view. But if you're doing things basic like changing column widths and moving columns around, then this layout view is a good view. Now, what I'd like to do in this layout view is try and change maybe the width of the columns, maybe some of the alignment. I'm going to click on the field name at the top. Actually, let me click down on the elements below the field name. You see when I click on one, it selects them all. I'm going to use Control to highlight the actual label and then the fields below. And I'm going to point to any one of these edges. And when I see that horizontal arrow, I can click and drag. Now watch this. I'm going to click on Telephone, hold Control, click on the elements below, and then I'm going to use my arrow keys. I'm hitting my arrow keys to slide it over. Click on Hand, hold Control, click the numbers below. I'm going to try and resize this. I see that horizontal arrow. Click and drag. I'm going to use my arrow keys. And actually, while I'm at this, I have the field name and then the elements below selected. I'm going to go to Format and say Left. Click Left. And now I'm going to come over to Cell Price. Click, hold Control, and click and slide, changing the width with that horizontal arrow. And then I'll use my arrow keys to scoot it over. And then finally, I can use the horizontal scroll bar over here to move the description. I used Control to highlight the field name and the elements below. Arrow keys. I'm going to go to Home, View, Print Preview, and see what that looks like. All right, so that's OK for our reorder phone list. And then you can see the dates at the bottom. Control S, and then close this. All right, so now we have two reports at the bottom. All right, so Access, we saw how to create tables in video 47. We saw how to create all these queries in video 48. And then in video 49, we created some reports. All right, now the next video will show you how to just export to Excel and to PDF. And then that'll be it for Access. All right, we'll see you next video.